Good morning, naturally. Good morning, Wayne. It is a naturally beautiful morning out here at the Lake Metro Park Farm Parks. See, the sun comes out. Must be you, Adam.
I think it might be. We're hoping for a
little sunshine. Yeah, because, I mean,
the weather. Wet night.
Yeah, it was. I was like, okay, we're going to be out here with like over 200 tractors and farm machines. Very cool. The Historical Society. You guys have been doing this show for over 50 years, right?
That's correct.
That's pretty cool.
We're back in our hometown of Kirtland after a long time of Burton, Ohio. This is our second year of Farm Park.
Excellent. Over 200 last year. You had over 200 vehicles, and this year
That's correct.
The same-ish?
It's going to be about the same. Now, they're still rolling in, and they'll be coming in all the way through Friday morning. So
now this
we're hoping to have a great turnout.
This is going to be one of the stars of the show. This is a steam engine
that is
tractor.
Correct.
I mean, this is probably one of the oldest we have out here, I would assume.
Yes, it actually would be the oldest that we have out here. We're the Historical Engine Society. It is a 1904 boiler on there made by Case.
Wow.
Racine, Wisconsin.
So the same principles that we saw with the steam engine trains that built the country, they said, wait a minute, let's make a compact version, if such a thing, right?
That was exactly the thinking. They used that same way of thinking to help out in agriculture, to power machines that had previously either been horsepower or man-driven.
Unbelievable. So in terms of one that's actually working and functioning, is this pretty rare, Adam, to get one of these?
It is getting to be pretty rare to have them. They never made a lot.
Yeah.
Case, I believe overall, made about 40,000 engines.
Back in the
day.
They
were the largest producer of them.
Wow. And then during the show, you'll hook that the flywheel up to the belt, and then what's the fan thing?
That's called a Baker fan.
Okay.
It's named after its inventor, Abner Baker. He was from Ohio.
Cool.
It's a power testing device that they used at the factory in Swanton, Ohio. It's actually got a calculation that goes with it to calculate horsepower relative to speed.
So basically a diagnostic back then, a diagnostic.
Break-in device, diagnostic tool, or measuring device.
Over here, what centuries are we talking about here, and what are we looking at here, Adam?
So what we have here is a Baker Gas tractor.
Okay.
It was actually built by the same company that built the fan.
Okay.
Swanton, Ohio, so that's a local tractor.
All right.
After things converted from steam, they went to gas, large gas tractors like this.
Uh-huh.
Have a couple Rumley oil pulls.
Okay.
They don't actually run on oil. They run on kerosene or gasoline.
Interesting.
But they cool with oil.
Ah, wow.
So a little bit different than using antifreeze.
And then as we wrap up, these last two, the Hart Parr and the Avery.
The Hart Parr and the Avery are both what we would also call prairie tractors.
Okay.
They were mainly used for belt work, running things like the threshing machine that we see over on the other side of the grounds, or a corn chopper.
All right.
And also,
and last
they could do
but
a little
not
field
least,
work.
Yeah, the Avery. Okay.
Yes, we have the big Avery. That's a very rare piece. Nice restoration on that one.
Living history lessons out here at the farm park all weekend long. I mean, that's what's really cool, because they'll be able to talk to you guys, and you guys can basically give a history lesson to everything.
Absolutely. The owners will be present with these throughout the show. This stuff's going to be running.
Love it. All right. Well, lots to show you guys when we come back. Tons of farmer equipment. The biggest tractor show in Northeast Ohio right here at Lake Metro Park Farm Park. Stay with us.